So the amount of change measured in digits from the vertical is called a camera angle. So So this is the first camera angle, this is the second camera angle. So it's a camera angle, so present, based on the time moment we can observe. So this is the first camera angle. So if time is tilted outside, you can find a first camera angle. Time is tilted inside, then there is a multi camera angle. You will see the depression of camera. Any amount of camera may be positive or negative. It tends to cause uneven or more tear wear on one side than the other side. Camera should not exceed 2 degrees. Because when the AC is loaded, the camera automatically reduces to 0. That means before loading, there is some camera angle. After loading, the camera becomes zero. The purpose of camera is to prevent the top of the heat from tilting too much because of excess load. So suppose if there is no camera, sometimes the tilting is too much towards inside. There is another angle called tilting inclination. So this red colored port is the tilted. This tilted makes, the tilted center line makes the angle with the vertical line, that is called tilted inclination. This angle is between the tilting position of the tilting from the vertical axis and view from the front of the wheel. So sometimes this tilted inclination also called as a steering axis inclination, STI. The tilted inclination is also called as steering axis inclination. So what is the necessity of tilted inclination? So tilted inclination is necessary due to the following reason. It allows straight ahead recovery after taking curve, thus providing direct stability. So due to tilted inclination, after turning again, for recovery of this steering, this tilting inclination helps and it provides the direction stability. It makes the operation of the steering quite easy, particularly when the vehicle is stationary. And it helps in reducing wear and the time. So these are the requirements of this inclination. Now we have discussed camber angle and tilting angle. The combined angle means the sum of the camber angle and tilting inclination is called as combined angle. The sum of the camber angle and tilting inclination is called as combined angle, and generally combined angle is 10 degrees. So the combined angle also is here also you can see the combined angle. So the combined angle, the angle is important because it determines the point of intersection. This combined angle, this camber line and tilting line, both sometimes it intersect. Already we discussed below the ground or above the ground or on the ground. So this angle is important because it determines the point of intersection of wheels and tilting center line. So the point of intersection is above the ground, the gear tends to show in. Okay? So, in the point of intersection, this point of intersection is below the ground, this is a show in. So in means both front wheel, front side, comes closer. The point of intersection is underground, the wheel. The point of intersection is above the ground, the wheel is towed in. The point of intersection is below the ground, the wheel tends to tow out. Tow out means the wheel will tow out. That means back side of the front wheel comes closer. The point of intersection is underground, the position is called center point steering where there is no tow in and there is no tow out. Regarding what is tow in and what is tow out in this letter. There is another parameter called scrum. Trump radio. Trump radio means the distance between the forward back to court point and the road restriction action point is called Trump radio. Okay, so this is the part here. This point is called left side point is called road restriction action point. This is another point is called forward back to court action point. The distance between these two points is called a trump radius. Generally, normal conditions will be 12 mm. So, sometimes trump radius is positive, sometimes it is zero, and sometimes it is negative. So, when it is positive means, since an axis means the center line below the ground, since an axis means the center line below the ground, those are the here, there is a show out. Below the ground, there is a show out. If the axis meets this on the ground, then there is no zero. Probability is zero. If it is above the ground, this probability is negative. There is another important parameter, capture. Capture means how much information this kingpin makes with the vertical. So this is a kingpin. This is a kingpin. How much information it makes with the vertical line? It is called capture. Generally it is 2 to 4 degrees. The capture angle will be 2 to 4 degrees. So here again there is a backward tilt and forward tilt will be. So when the vehicle is moving towards forward direction and this tilt will move towards backward, it is backward tilt. When the angle back side of the vertical line, that is called backward inclination. And the kingpin inclination is takes forward direction, then it is called this is the forward, this is backward capture and this is the forward capture. So what is the use of capture means? The capture angle. So it provides easy steering. What is the use of this capture angle means? The capture angle provides easy steering. Okay, generally the capture angle varies from 2 to 8 degrees. Okay. So here this is the capture angle. And coming to the show in and show out. So show in means for front wheels, both the front portion of the wheel comes closer. Then it is called show-in. Okay. So show-in is defined as the amount of by which the front wheels are set closer together at the front than the rear. It is easy to provide a better direction stability for the vehicle by decreasing oversteer. It also prevents tire slipping and excessive wear on the tire. Under actual practice, show in kept around 3 mm. Coming to the show out. Show out means the front portion of the wheels are tight or far away and the back portion of this wheel comes closer, that is called show out. This is exact opposite to the show in. When front portion comes closer, it is a show in, and the back end portion comes closer, it is a show out. So, these are the various steering geometry. In steering geometry, we have discussed what is the importance of steering geometry, what are the various geometry parameters, that is, what is camber angle, what is incident relation, what is the combined angle, what is provided in this coverage areas, what is in the point of intersection, what is in the collision, and what is in the toehold. These are all play very important role in wheel alignment of an automobile. Thank you.